Bayard was at heart a militant and revolutionary in the fight for civil rights.
Bayard Rustin served as a trusted advisor to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. during the Montgomery bus boycott, but he's better known for organizing the iconic 1963 March on Washington.
The one man in America who could do it did it, and that's why it happened. It had an architect. His name was Bayard Rustin.
But in a time when intolerance ran high, Rustin stood out for more than just his work on civil rights.
It was just one of these facts of life. Bayard is gay. He doesn't hide it. I said to somebody once that he never knew there was a closet to go into.
Bayard had been attacked both for his homosexuality and his also his political views.
Strom Thurmond did it on the floor of the United States Senate.
Thurmond referenced Rustin's 1953 arrest on a public sex charge.
The senator is interested in attacking me because he is interested in destroying the movement. He will not get away with this.
The march was a huge success and exceeded expectations, but it wasn't the first time Rustin's sexuality came under attack, sometimes from his own people, including the Democratic congressman from Harlem.
There was the possibility of a rumor being circulated by Adam Clayton Powell that Bayard Rustin and Martin Luther King Jr. were having an affair. King pressed Bayard to take a back seat and back off from the organizing in 1960 in the March on Conventions movement.
After the 1960s, Rustin continued to be a pro-labor and anti-apartheid activist. Yet to colleagues, he never seemed to get his due recognition.
Clearly, somebody as charismatic and was as brilliant as Bayard Rustin, yet was not able to establish or become a leader in the same sense of all the civil rights leaders of that time. He was being held back by the fact that he was a homosexual.
Now, 26 years after his death, Rustin will be awarded the nation's highest civilian honor, the Medal of Freedom.
Nobody did it better than Bayard Rustin, so I became something of a disciple of Bayard Rustin.
When you were with Bayard, you really believed that you were in the presence of history and that you were going to change the way America worked.
Don Lemon, CNN, New York.